Jamestown was the first successful English colony, but its success was never guaranteed. During the 1609 famine known as the Starving Time, many of the early English colonists died, and some claim to have heard of instances of cannibalism. There were some modern historians who did not believe cannibalism really occurred at Jamestown, until an archaeological dig in 2012 uncovered evidence of cannibalism. History is what was written down, but archaeology uncovers what was left behind. Not everything that happened in the past made it into a history textbook today, but with archaeology, we can fill in what's missing from the story. Say you find a part of that missing story. You discover something left behind by people who lived a few decades, even a few hundred years ago. Let's say you discovered an artifact, something created or used by human beings in the past. You might be looking at the key to uncovering an archaeological site that could change how we understand the past, or just another piece of pottery. What should you do about that artifact? Today, we're going to tell you the four-step process to follow if you find an artifact. Step 1, leave it where you found it. If the object is not in any immediate danger, do not try to move it. Artifacts are most valuable when they tell us more about the people who made them. And artifacts tell us the most when they are found in their original context. Also, artifacts belong to the owner of the land they were found on. If you find it on your own land, you won't lose it if you report it. But if it is not your land, please do not take anyone else's stuff. Back to context. Context is where an artifact was found, where it was in the ground, what layer of soil it was in, and what was found around it, including other artifacts. As an example, during excavation of a former freedwoman Sukik's cabin in the park, archaeologists discovered a plate with the alphabet on it. That plate would serve as an important learning tool when teaching children how to read and write, something every newly freed family after the Civil War wanted to do. By finding it in its original context, we now know more about the artifact, its users and purpose, and its owners or creators. If someone had taken them away from the site and all we had was the plate fragments, we would not know anything about who had used it or even how it was used. To keep our artifact story whole, leave the artifact where it is and instead take a picture. It doesn't have to be a great one. Just get close enough to show the detail and give a good idea of what it is you're looking at. If you can, try to place something next to the artifact for scale. Driver's licenses, coins, library cards are common items you might have on you that have pretty set sizes and can serve as references for scale in a pinch. Now you need to record your artifact's location. Try to find a reference point and then take a picture of your artifact against that reference point so it is easier to find later. If you have a smartphone that has a GPS app with you, try to get the GPS coordinates for your find. If you can't get the coordinates, write them down or send them as a message to yourself. If you don't have a smartphone, try your best to remember the location of the artifact by writing down the area you found it in. Record the city, address, and other location information, and of course, the path that you took to get there. Now that you have some pictures of the artifact and its location, you need to contact someone with the appropriate archaeological credentials. Look up your state historic preservation office. In Maryland, that would be the Maryland Historical Trust, or MHT. At the MHT, you'll want to contact the state terrestrial archaeologist, who at the time of this video is Charles Hall. Give them the photos, the location, and as much other information as you have, and the hard part is over. Now, you just wait for a response. Don't worry if it takes a while for your state's historic preservation office to get back to you. They only have so many staff, and they work over the entire state. If you are eager to learn just what it is you found, you can also visit our website, jeffpatt.org, and click the Artifact ID link. This will have instructions to send pictures of the artifact to the Maryland Archaeological Conservation Lab, or MAC Lab, where an expert can examine the artifact for you and tell you more information about what you found. While the MAC Lab can help you figure out what the object is, you're helping us learn how it was used by following this simple four-step process. Congratulations, you successfully reported a find. Thank you for helping us to tell a more complete story of the past.